When you think of education, you usually think of teachers and faculty, the people who provide the instruction in the classrooms. What you don't often think about are the people behind the scenes.
There's an intersection between data and education that I searched really hard to get training on how to solve. Like, I wanted to be prepared to step into those two overlapping fields. I saw solely education-focused programs like education management administration, and I saw statistical-only heavy programs. And out of all that, it was such a relief to find this program because it was the kind of like the perfect overlap of the worlds that I'm interested in, the data analysis world and the education world.
The data in and of itself isn't the goal. I think that how we use data to inform some of the change that we want to see, whether at the community level, at the institutional level, you know, is where the real innovative work, where the passion that each of us may bring to our work gets to flourish.
I don't think you need the coding or, you know, the extensive statistical knowledge like R programming, but you do need that love for data and wanting to make a change with that data. Data speaks volumes. It just takes individuals to really hone in and extract what is needed from that data to make decisions.
I'm a storyteller that uses evidence. In order to tell a story, I have to situate different types of data collected at different points in time in a way that makes sense. And the best way for me to do that is to understand the various experiences that faculty, staff, and particularly our students are encountering.
The data analysis component, the evaluation component, gives you a skill set, a toolbox to tackle problems that maybe you wouldn't have normally been able to tackle. So there's not one specific type of problem or one problem that EEDA is designed to tackle, but rather it's providing you with a framework to tackle problems that you wouldn't have been able to tackle before, you know, without data skills, without evaluation skills, without survey design skills.
The typical pathway through the program for an EEDA student will be they'll start with educational evaluation and have an introduction to data methodologies. They'll move into that by taking a course in statistics and then a course in qualitative data gathering, which is about learning how to do focus groups and interviews. At that point, then they'll move into data management, leveraging your data, which is about data storytelling. And they also take a course on learning how to do their own survey on a project management schedule. And then finally, it gets wrapped up in a practicum that they do at the very end, where they conduct a project and then showcase it as part of their employment portfolio.
Southern California and CGU being in Southern California is really wonderful. Its location, first and foremost, in the Claremont Consortium allows so much access to both graduate and undergraduate students and professors. So you really are exposed to a wide variety of professionals and fields and individuals working at universities all over the Southern California area.
The kinds of students that I think would thrive in this field are inherently curious, are committed to sustainable change that may not come quick, but is something that we can continue to work at.
EEDA meets a need that hasn't been directly met before. It's been met accidentally by people falling into data because they're in education, or people in data falling into education.
Right now, there is a lot of organizations that are collecting data, student data, educational surveys. So the need is for, you know, individuals to be data translators.
I'm coming in as someone who's spent 20 years plus in the professional world. So having come back to get my doctorate degree, there was a lot of information in my ed I already had. The idea was what was I going to add to my portfolio that was going to enhance my knowledge and bring new information to the work that I actually do.
When I talk to other students who are also in the program, one thing we really enjoy is the fact that though there are core classes, it is flexible. We all work in different fields, different levels of education, some in higher ed, some in, you know, K-12 education.
2.5 years ago, when we started looking for this program, we knew that data analyst positions were rising. So we're looking for those new positions who are research analysts, data analysts, assistant directors of research, assistant directors of evaluation programs.
And then there's K-12. So basically, I'm employable anywhere if I wanted to be. I just need to pick up my cause, take my tool bag, and then go tackle stuff.
The interesting thing about institutional researchers is we get an array of requests, and the topic is just vast. So having that skill set to be able to pivot from something that is very kind of in the weeds of what are our music students learning and how do we know that they're learning it, to how do we know that our graduates actually have learned the competency of communication skills.
Research is like a form of passing the mic and turning on the spotlight. If people aren't looking into something in a systematic way and then calling out with a microphone, hey, look, there's a problem over here, and calling out to the right people that are interested in those problems or making them interested in those problems, then it's not gonna be the focus because there's so many other problems that people will be focused on. So in my mind, research is a way of going humbly to the community of whoever you're researching, your subjects, asking them, what needs to happen, or what have you experienced? How do we change it? How do we make it better? And then taking those voices and then elevating them to the decision makers.
We are looking for students who love data. They see data as part of what drives them. They love getting in. They want to go beyond a spreadsheet, and they want to dig deeper into how data informs decisions and helps leverage change.